Good morning. This is your Monday 7:07. Kama kawaida, thank you for tuning in. It's always a pleasure to have you and to have some sunshine. Last time we had a really cold morning. And today I'm talking to you about covenant brothers or sisters. Okay? Now, my grandpa and grandma are very up in age, and they've got somebody who has been with them, taking care of them, taking care of their food, taking care of the farm. His name is Makori. Shout out to Makori. Makori has been with my grandparents for about 50 years, as in since my parents were in school. He's been with them and he's taken care of them. And now my grandpa is 97, actually 98 years old, and he's been with them all this time. And I was just thinking about it, and this thing blew my mind. And today I want to talk to you about people that I call covenant brothers or covenant sisters. Some people call them confidants. Some people call them burden bearers. I don't know what you call them, but they are people in life that are called to you as a person. Now, this is an extension of what we've been talking about in terms of relationships, all right? We've been talking about the power of relationships, and over this series, I want to talk to you about three kinds of relationships. There are people who are called to the king, there are people who are called to the cause, and then there are people that are called to the crown, okay? The crown is your glory, the things you do great, your success, and all that. There are people that are called to that. Now, the cause is what you do, your profession, what you're good at. There are people that are called to you in that regard. But today I'm talking to the people, and I'm talking about the people that are called to the king. These are people that are passionate about you as an individual. They are called burden bearers. They are called covenant brothers. People that are not interested in how you succeed. They'll go with you anywhere. They will live with you. They'll spend their entire lives with you. I don't know if you've had them or seen them in life. They're very rare, but they're very precious. Some of us have got a house help that has been with you guys or with your parents for over 20 years. Some of you have got, I've seen someone who is a driver who has been with somebody all the way for like their entire career. Could be a driver, it could be a parent, it could be a personal assistant. There are people that stay in the background. They are not really excited about the limelight. They don't stand in the limelight, but they are passionate about you as an individual. If you are fortunate enough to have these kinds of people around you or around people that matter to you, you need to treasure them deeply because they are a special breed of people. You see, a number of us, and most of us, are excited about the crown. We're excited about other people's success. So when you see someone is the best architect or someone has the best company or they have the best salary, so we come for that, and that's good, that's fine. But there's a special breed of people that don't look at the salary. They somehow follow you everywhere that you go. They're excited about you as a person. And so they are able, they have an uncanny capacity to see the king even when he's not wearing his crown. So other people are going to wait for when you are wearing your crown, then they know, ah, this is a king. They wait for you when you succeed, then they come to the party. But this special breed of covenant brothers are the people that will be there after everybody has finished clapping and they have left. When the party is over and guys have gone, these are the guys who will still be sweeping the floor and saying, it's okay, I can spend the night. These are the people that will be in the kitchen when you're hosting your guests. Are you getting me? These are the people that will always support you. Even when everybody leaves you, when the crowd leaves you, these are the people that will always be there. They remain in your presence. Why? Because they are somehow passionate about you. So if you have these kinds of people, you need to shelter them. And most of these people, many times, are there around successful people. If you've got a big calling in your life, if you are a big person who's got a big responsibility in this life to touch many lives, you're going to find that you have people around you that are very passionate about you as an individual. They look like they don't have a lot of ambition. You know, the funny thing with these guys is they look like they don't have an ambition for themselves. It's like they don't have a career of themselves. You are their career. You leave the country, they leave the country with you. You move from Runda to Ruai, they move with you. You move from Kitengela to Nairobi, they move with you. They are so committed to you. Have you ever seen these kinds of people? The reason I'm talking to you today is I want to tell you that when you find these people, you need to treasure them. And sometimes you may look at them and they look like they are not ambitious, like they don't want to study, they don't want to go to school to better themselves. My friend, let me tell you something. If they went to school to better themselves, they would not be with you. If they were ambitious and they wanted their own crown, they would not stick with you. But they will stick with you. That is seen as lack of ambition is a sign of their commitment to you. So don't look down on them. If you're fortunate enough to have them, there are two things that I want you to do. Number one, you need to make sure that you take care of them. Take care of their families, because they don't know how to ask for a raise. They don't know how to push you for better terms of engagement. Make sure that you take care of them. Take care of their salary. Take care of their benefits. Take care of their families. Take care of their well-being, their health. Look out for them, because they don't know how to look out for themselves. The second thing that I want you to do is make sure that you give them FaceTime, because they are very comfortable to be behind the scenes. These are guys who are not looking for that limelight, so you can easily miss them. And because most of them are called to great people, you're going to find that you are around the limelight, you are around other big people that are called to your crown, and you can fail to see them. Make sure that you carve out time to give them FaceTime, because the one thing that attracts them is not the money that you pay them, it's your presence. So carve out time to be with them. They feed off your energy. They feed off spending time with you. That's their calling. That's their life. That's their passion. That is what fuels them. That's what gives them a sense of purpose. That's what gives them a sense of satisfaction. So carve out time to spend time with them. Ask them, how are you doing? How is life going? How are your kids? How's your husband? How's your wife? Talk to them. That is going to refuel them. All right. And finally, if you are a burden bearer, I want to talk to you and tell you, you are a special breed of person. You're a special breed of people. You are a unique person. All right. And the reason why you've been called to these people, because you've probably been called with someone. I'm talking to someone you've been a PA for the same person for 20 years, 10 years. I'm talking to someone you've been working for somebody else for the past 15 years. And people make fun of you. Guys keep asking you, hey, boss, why is it? Why aren't you looking for another job? You've sat in this place for too long. Listen, I know you, and you're passionate about this person. You're passionate about their success. I want to tell you this, the reason you are called to them, the reason you are drawn to them is because they carry a vision that is massive and they cannot make it on their own. So no matter how arrogant they may be, no matter how selfish sometimes they may be, stay true to your cause. Stay true to that person. Continue to serve them. Continue to reach out to them. Continue to do your purpose in their lives. Because without you, they will never be anything. Without you, they cannot carry that heavy responsibility that's on their shoulders. So I want to tell you that you are valued. And every person that person's business or that person's life touches is going to be credited to you. And there are no free lunches in life. You will get what's coming to you. You will get paid in full. Sometimes it may not be even in your lifetime, but your kids will be paid in full. Somehow, life will conspire to make sure that you, as a covenant brother or a covenant sister of a great man, you are going to end up paid in full for everything that you have given to this person that you're serving. This is our series on relationships, and today we are talking about covenant brothers and sisters. I hope you've been inspired, whoever you are, whichever side of that relationship that you are in. This is your Monday 707. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Victor Machoka. Always a pleasure. See you next week.